Let's guide the youngsters and the adults so that they understand that they must only wash that which is beneficial. They must only wash that which is going to give them the sunnah in their lives. Put ikhlas in your life. Put sincerity in your life. This can be a way of making sure that people understand the deen Islam, the legacy of Muhammad who always lived. The Quran is giving us good news. Good news that guides us in this universe and the hereafter, brothers and sisters.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitani rajim. Bismillahi ar-Rahmani ar-Rahim. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri. واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي فقد قال الله عز وجل في القرآن المجيد بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم والعسر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر يا الإخوة الكرام أحييكم بأطيب التحية تحية أهل الجنة السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته Brothers and sisters in Islam watching from all parts of the world on ITV networks, www.itvnetworks.tv. And all people that are watching on DSTV channel 347. Let us be mindful that our life in public and our life in private must conform according to the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So today, my beautiful topic is called public life and private life. Life is a journey in which all of us we can get trapped by the whisperings of shaitan regime, either in public or in private. So Allah will judge us according to our good deeds in private life and in public life. So brothers in Islam, indeed, Allah knows our public life and private life. So that's why Allah says in the Quran, بَعْدَ أَعُوذِ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ إن الله عالم غيب السماوات والأرض إنه عليم بذات الصدور The meaning of which is إن الله عالم غيب السماوات والأرض Allah knows the غيب or the secrets all the secrets in the world He knows and everything that we do in secret Allah knows in the skies and on earth إنه Alimum bidhati sudur. And he is a knower of whatever, even what is in the breast of human beings. He knows all the secrets that we keep on our hearts, whatever we're thinking. So you mustn't think today that just because I'm somewhere in my bedroom or somewhere underground, because we know some people got houses which have got bunkers, especially those people that have got palaces or that have got villas and these posh houses. They like to build bunkers or underground homes. So you mustn't think that if you've got an underground home or a bunker, Allah cannot see you. Even if you try to hide in the cave, Allah can see you. So why should we straighten our public life and private life? Why? Number one, day of judgment, we are answerable to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for whatever we did in private and public life. So that's why it is said that kullukum ra'in وَكُلُّكُمْ مَسْعُولٌ عَنْ رَأِيَّتِهِ That all of us were like shepherds. Shepherds are responsible for herding the sheep. So the doctor is responsible for the patients. The teacher is responsible for the students. The mother and the father, they're responsible for what? For the children. So likewise, we all responsible people. So and we're answerable on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah or on the day of judgment. So brothers and sisters in Islam, we're watching on ITV networks. I urge you, make sure that your private life is up to date, especially with the Sunnah of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Your public life also must conform with the Sunnah of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Brothers and sisters in Islam, we are facing what are called the modern times. In the modern times, there's so many things going on. And there's so many aspects of vice or of sin that have become so extreme that it's unimaginable what's going on in the world. Imagine the killings that are going on in the world in secret. Imagine the robberies and the fraud that is going on in secret globally. So we have to equip ourselves with the life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That is why it is said in the Quran, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ That there was indeed a great paradigm, a great example in Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So brothers and sisters in Islam, straighten up your private life. Straighten up your public life to conform with the akhlaq of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or the character of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So brothers in Islam, we must have good relations with our neighbors. That is part of being good in public life. So the Quran mentions qurba, those who are close to us. We must be good with them. Why? Because this is part of da'wah. That's why they say in English, action speaks louder than words. Sometimes you can put on a kurta or your garment, but this does not mean that you're 100% Muslim. There's some Muslims that would look like they're wearing nice kurta and all that, but they're two-faced. They're hypocrites. They have no Islam inside their hearts. So Allah is watching you. You must remember that. Inna Allah alimun bidhati sudur. And Allah is well aware of whatever is in the hearts of men. He knows everything that is in the hearts of men. Inna Allah sami'un basir. Allah is, he can hear and can see whatever you do. So we must be very careful of what we do in public to society. Like nowadays, you'll find some Muslims, even they in public life, they would hate even Christians. They would hate people of other sects. This is not right. For us to make them to be attracted to the religion of Islam is by us behaving in a good way. The name Muhammad or the name Hassan or the name Muhsin does not guarantee you that you're a good Muslim. What guarantees you is how you follow the Quran and how you follow the Hadith. So brothers in Islam, we must also in public life be good to our children. It's very important. Sometimes we find parents that sexually abuse their children, that physically abuse their children, that emotionally abuse their children. So all this, it does not conform to the akhlaq or the character of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So brothers in Islam, would you love in public life to be disgraced? Like some parents, one parent in England, they say his son could not memorize the Quran. And the parent beat the child to death. The child was beaten to death. So is that good as a Muslim to beat a child to death in that way? Then what happened to this sister? The sister was imprisoned. So in public life now, people are going to see Islam in a wrong way. That Islam is a religion of only forcing. No, Islam is not a religion of forcing, but it's a religion of being practical. It's a religion of actions. Action speaks louder than words. So brothers and sisters in Islam, what are the ways of us to improve our public life and our private life? Number one, we must always perform our salah, because salah actually helps us to stay away from vices. Tanha anil fahsha'i wal munkar. That surely salah, it helps us to refrain from all the munkarat, all the evil things, all the things that are obscene. Salah helps us to stay away from all these vices. Why is it like that? Because by the time you wake up for Fajr, you perform firstly your wudu. Wudu means ablution. So this ablution, like when you're washing your hands, you'll be like, I don't want to touch anything that is haram. Or when you're washing your mouth, I don't want to say anything from my mouth, with my mouth, which is not good. At the same time, when washing your face, your nostrils, all this, you're cleansing yourself. Say, I don't want any evil, to see any evil with my eyes. Cleansing your head, whatever you hear, whatever you think must be clean. Cleansing your back, everything, your cleaning of your body is like cleaning to say, no, I don't need anything evil, which is not a clean near me, either internally or externally. So brothers in Islam and sisters in Islam that are watching ITV, let us be mindful that today, change your life, which is public. Change your life, which is private. Sometimes you must spice up your life. How you spice it? Don't only pray in public to show your friends or your colleagues that you're a Muslim. Don't only wear the garment to just be in public to look like Muslim, but in your heart, there's no true Islam. Because you'd find some people, they will perform 5 daily salats, but their behavior in public is bad. They don't have a good heart. They don't have love in them. They hate other people. So spice up your life in this way. In private, try to wake up for your Fajr Salah. In private, try to wake up for your Tahajjud Salah. It's only like 4 rakats or 12 rakats. So in this way, your private life will be spiced up. And Allah will give you blessings in this dunya and akhirah. Do not do any secret sins. What are secret sins? These are some of the acts that human beings do. not knowing that no one can see me. Sometimes someone can say, no, I'm going to smoke Zol. Nobody can see me. I'll commit zina, no one will see me. I'll drink alcohol, no one will see me. So these are secret sins. Try by all means to avoid secret sins. Because Allah is Sami'un Basir. So Allah can see whatever you do. Whatever you do in secret and in openly, Allah can see all those activities you do. So it's very important for us not to be hypocritical. Let us be people of ikhlas. Let us be people of sincerity. That's why the hadith says, Ayatul Nafiq, Thalatha. Idha haddatha kadaba, wa idha wa'ad akhlafa, wa idha tumina khan. That there are three signs of a hypocrite, or a two-faced person, or a munafiq. When he speaks, he lies. When he is entrusted, when he's entrusted with a trust, he actually betrays this trust. When whatever you give him for amana or trustworthy, he deceives. He doesn't fulfill his promises. So basically, this is why it is very important that when you want to represent Islam, to be an ambassador of Islam, you must make sure that your private life and public life is in order. But we're not saying human beings should be 100% perfect. Nobody's perfect. But try to be near perfect. Try. Try, make a plan. So brothers and sisters in Islam, you and me, we've been listening about how to shape our life, our private life, in public life into order. So inshallah, we're taking a short break, and please do not run away. Just pause a little bit, drink some coffee, drink some juice, or drink some water, and wait for our next segment. Inshallah, we'll be giving you ingredients of how to spice up and make your private life and public life to conform with the akhlaq or the character of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Let's guide the youngsters and the adults so that they understand that they must only wash that which is beneficial. They must only wash that which is going to give them the sunnah in their lives. Put ikhlas in your life. Put sincerity in your life. This can be a way of making sure that people understand the deen Islam, the legacy of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who always lived. The Quran is giving us good news. Good news that guide us in this universe and the hereafter, brothers and sisters.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Brothers and sisters in Islam watching on DSTV channel 347 ITV Networks. Welcome back to a beautiful topic which is called private life and public life. So brothers in Islam, we are speaking on how to spice up your public life and private life with the sunnah or the akhlaq of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or the beautiful character, sublime character of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So one of the main points we have to understand is that when you want to make your life of private or public life to be good in the way which was taught by Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is that of putting a tablet called being honest. Try to be honest with yourself. Try to put honesty with your friends, with the society, and within yourself. At the same time, don't be near zina. This harnesses your chances of spoiling your private life. So many times, we all know that shaitan whispers the hearts of men, Alladhi yuwaswisu fi suduri nas, the one who whispers in the hearts of men. So it is very important for you to always what you have what is called firewall. Firewall, you know, every computer, any kind of virus, which one attack the computer, there's firewall and there's antivirus. So have your own antivirus of the body or your own firewall. So this firewall will help you that when shaitan comes, you say, no, I don't do drugs. I don't commit zina. I don't sleep around. This is not from the akhlaq or the character of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So having a firewall within you will help you each and every day to survive these times when shaitan is whispering so heavily in our societies. So another point is avoid pornography. Avoid any negative cartoons and any negative TV channels that teaches vices. And watch your type of friends. Because some people, they suffer due to peer pressure. If the friend can say, let's take some drugs, or let's go and see some girls, which is haram. Let's go and see something that is bad. Some friends can say, also, let's go and do things that are not confirming to the Sunnah of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So basically, we must be very careful of who is our friend. Some of the friends, they can even tell you, no, besides Salah, let's go and do something else. Salah, we're going to do it tomorrow or later on. So that's not a good friend. So what is the best? Surround yourself with motivational and inspirational friends. Always keep a group of inspirational friends. Friends that can give you hope or solace in your life. The other way is that befriend imam. Let the imam be your friend or a religious leader. A religious leader must be your friend. The closer you are to the religious leader, the closer you get information of how to survive in the world according to the akhlaq or the sunnah of Muhammad Anbiya alayhim salam. So brothers and sisters in Islam, also another point is secretly don't smoke zol. Don't smoke zol in secret. Try by all means to open up about your problem to the imams and the muftis and the people who are doing religious work. Tell them your problem. I have a problem. I'm addicted to drugs. In which way can I change the way I do things in my life? Because if I don't do this, I'm actually destroying the legacy of my children. I'm also destroying my own legacy, and I'm also destroying the environment that I live in and the people that live in my environment. So likewise, brothers in Islam, secret also, don't watch what you read in secret. Many times there's a lot of this media hype. Some of the media is good. Some of the media is very disadvantageous and very dangerous to the society. So some modern print also can twist the mind of people. We all know about the rituals of Satanism. There's a lot of Satanism going on. So some people can come across all this information and they twist their public life and their private life. So it is very important also to be very careful about how you what you read. Results of change. Results of changing your private life and your public life. Number one, one, religious and physical improvement. Your health itself, your health, it improves. Your what? Your religious institution or religious way of doing things, you improve so much. I have heard so many successful stories of people that have changed their lives. And they start to pray, they start to conform with the Sunnah of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. They come with good results. Some even quit smoking. Some even quit taking drugs or smoking zol. So that's why Allah SWT says, "Inna Allah la yughayru ma biqawmin hatta yughayru ma bi anfusihim." That Allah does not change the condition of a community unless that community changes itself. So another point also, what happens when you change your public and private life is that you develop development. You develop. Sometimes maybe economically you also start to change. Sometimes also society, people respect you. They give you a good status if you change. Number three, you gain what is called maturity. You become mature and you know how to even advise other people. You also be like a mentor. We've heard of Malcolm X. Malcolm X, they said before he became a Muslim, he was a thug, he was a desperado, he was a rogue, he was a man who didn't use to live like the Sunnah of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He was also a racist. But the moment he seek to change his public life and private life, what Malcolm X changed to become a good person. So likewise in life, you yourself can emulate and can be like Malcolm X, who changed his life. So brothers in Islam, piety. Brothers in Islam, piety is very, very important. And also sisters in Islam, piety is important. So if you change your public and private life, you will find that even piety, you gain a lot of piety. I was watching a program on YouTube. This program was talking about a sister. In fact, the sister was even giving a talk in that program. That her name is Sister Zainab. She was from, it is written, the topic is from Hollywood to Islam. The sister was one of the key figure behind the scenes who used to train these Hollywood actors. And she used to say that, she used to do all the evil vices, training all these actors from Hollywood. But she changed after some time in her life, after an accident. She rolled with a car, with a brand new car, 5 times. And from that moment, she started to ponder about life. Later on, she embraced Islam. So her story is that she changed her public life and her private life, and she embraced Islam. After that, she even gained piety. She was used to wear wrong dress, which is not Islamic. But in that talk, in that program on YouTube, she was wearing Islamic wear, covering all her body parts, covering her jewelry. Because as you know, the body of a woman is private. So she must keep it private, and she must keep it in a chaste way or a modest way. So in this way, the sister improved her life. So you never know, Allah will grant you a paradise. So another point is that rich in faith. You become rich in faith if you decide to change your private life and public life. Another point is health is wealth. That's number 7. Health is wealth. So the more you improve your private life and public life, you also gain health. So health itself is wealth. And you get many good friends. You get a lot of many, many good friends. Because usually people are attracted to a person that changes in life. A person that is actually inspirational or motivational. So if you're just a friend who doesn't offer anything in life, you find that you won't get any friends. You'll be a lonely person every time and again. And another point, major point in this topic, public life and private life, is that Yusuf alayhi salam had a very good private life and public life. We all know the story of Yusuf alayhi salam, whom they call in English, Joseph, peace be upon him. In the Bible also is mentioned, in the Quran is mentioned. In private life, Yusuf controlled his feelings and acquired time. And Allah says in Surah Yusuf, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وَلَقَدْ هَمَّتْ بِهِ وَهَمَّ بِهَا لَوْلَا أَرْآ بُرْهَانَ رَبِّهِ كَذَلِكَ لَنَصْرِفَ عَنْهُ السُّوءَ وَالْفَحْشَاءَ إِنَّهُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا الْمُخْلَصِينَ. The meaning of which is, and indeed, she did desire him, and he would have inclined, him Yusuf, could have inclined to her desire. Had he not seen the evidence of his Lord, that it was that which might turn away from him evil and illegal sexual intercourse. Surely he was one of our chosen guided slaves. So this is from the Quran, that when the king's wife was trying to tempt or seduce Yusuf alayhi salam, Yusuf alayhi salam said, no, I am from the religious people. I want my private life to be cleaned. But Yusuf now said, no, I won't do this. Innahu min ibadina al-mukhlasin. Yusuf was from the servants who had ikhlas. He was from those servants from Almighty Allah who had sincerity in themselves. So he did not sleep with the king's wife. So likewise, this is what we should do in our lives. When a temptation comes to you, be strong. Say, no, I don't take drugs. I don't sleep around. I'm sorry. I can't do it. So then our private life will be good. So Yusuf alayhi salam controlled his sexual feelings. Give in private or in secret. So it is very important for us always to give our wealth in private or in secret. Many times people want to do show off. Someone will give you 100 rand and you tell the whole public, I gave you 100 rand, you remember. And you'll be saying this in front of people. So this is not right. But in a nutshell, sometimes give in public so that you teach others how to give. So in private also, you find that there's a story in Japan that a man gave out in secret. He just dropped like millions of dollars just to give to tsunami victims. So this we should do as Muslims. This will teach other people to be exemplary in society. So to conclude, brothers and sisters in Islam, let's try to be good in our public life and private life. Especially the communities are looking at us, society is looking at us. So let us make sure our private life and public life is very good. May Allah make it easy for us as Muslims to always make sure that our private life is conforming to the akhlaq or the character of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May Allah make it easy for us as Muslimin to always remember our 5 daily prayers. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.
تخرج من دنيا الورى